Today I'm in the Avondale neighborhood on the roof, private roof deck of a three-bedroom, two-bathroom apartment. The roof deck runs the entire size of the unit itself. There's outdoor, also some outdoor space. Here's the back door, outdoor patio, which most people would be more than happy to have. See nice downtown views. There's water up here, there's electricity, there's lights, there's water, so if you want to do an outdoor garden, it'd be very easy to do, which would be great up here. I think you could just grow a ton of things. Farm to table would be pretty short. There's looking over to lakefront. So on the other side of these townhomes is the Target on Addison. And again, more downtown views. From here, we'll go down into the apartment itself. It's three bedrooms and two bathrooms. Again, this is a private roof deck for you. Go down the stairs. This is that back door where the other deck was. Nice thing about this deck, you'll see there's a natural gas outlet. So if you want to do a grill with natural gas where you wouldn't have to worry about filling up with the little tanks and stuff and running out when it's most inconvenient, you could get a tank for natural, or a grill for natural gas. And have it. This kitchen, there's an under counter refrigerator or wine rack or juice box rack, whatever works for you. Stone countertops, the dishwasher, over the stove microwave, 42 inch shaker cabinet, stainless steel pulls, a Juliet balcony over there, gas fireplace. Look at the kitchen from this side. See the breakfast bar there? Has room for probably three, four bar stools. Here's the bottom of the stairs coming from the roof deck. Bedroom number one here, which will fit a queen-size bed, no problem. There are high ceilings here also. I'll probably say that a couple of times because sometimes I forget I've already said it. But I think it's worth mentioning. Nice big closet. Here you can see how high the ceilings are just by how much room there is between the top of the door and the ceiling. Continuing down the hallway, we go to bedroom number two. It's big, and this bedroom, I'll show you in a second, this bedroom would probably do a king-size bed, a queen-size bed for sure, just because of the way it's laid out. And one of the nice things about it, coming in the hallway there on the left, behind the entry door is the closet for this room, so it doesn't take up one of the walls. Here's the common bathroom. I'll try to stay out of the mirror. Tub and shower combination. Nice stainless steel accents. Stone countertop. White shaker cabinets. Here's the primary bedroom. That's the bedroom with the bathroom in it. It is huge. It will easily do a king-size bed. If you're looking to do a queen-size bed and an in-home desk or something like that, it's got room for it without a problem. Nice big bathroom, double vanity sinks, lots of storage below it. It's got a tub, separate tub and shower combination. This is the shower. Nice modern tile. On the other side over here, you see the tub is deep. It's also jetted. Nice big mirror that just makes it feel even more open than it is. So we're leaving the primary bedroom, heading up the hallway. On the right is the bathroom, a bedroom, central heating, air conditioning, gas forced heat. Another bedroom, a closet for when you come in the back door. A nice entry foyer. To the left was the lower deck. To the right is the stairs that go up to the private roof deck that you have. And one more look at this nice big open floor plan. Again, you can see how high the ceilings are by how much room there is between the top of the cabinets and the ceiling.